What's good, y'all? We back again with another pickup. I know it seems like that's all my content, but this is a special one because this is the birthday pickup edition. And so one thing about me is I don't really celebrate my birthday like that. I used to like maybe hanging out with a lot of people, but now I kind of don't feel the same way. But one thing I always do on my birthday is I'm gonna treat myself out and I'm gonna buy myself gifts. And this year I got carried away, I'm not gonna be honest. I treated myself out a little too hard. So honestly, with this video, like when I show you guys this, I don't really mean to be like flexing on y'all like that, because that's not what I'm trying to do. I really am just trying to show what I copped. So yeah, but with that said, just know I did myself a solid for my birthday. We 24 now, we gotta go hard. I'm only trying to go up, you know the vibes. Let me show you guys what I copped. We got a cool stuff on the rack, and I got some other stuff too. So yeah, first item, just to start off real light, and this is really like the order of when I just started buying stuff and just stopped thinking. First thing was I did go to 2nd Street, and I got this keychain right here. It's a Secret Vase / Verdi collab and the Star keychain. I got this Girls Don't Cry one already, so I really already just like the quality of the keychains that Verdi uses, so I figured why not. I've been using this carabiner very often, real nice on the pants. So yeah, but at that same 2nd Street, I finally caught myself a new backpack, and I got this. And for someone who's been rocking the same JanSport for 5 years, it's all beat up, like it has holes in it. I mean, the colors are, it's already decolored, everything. Finally having a new backpack feels good. And I caught this at the 2nd Street, I was able to get 10% off too. We got this undercover bag with the teddy bears on it. These pockets up front, I put a little Stussy keychain on it. Here are the straps up front, got these gold buckles. Yeah, it has these knots too on all the zippers, which is really cool. And the inside, you can see it has like a little, really simple. And I just figured I need a new backpack, it's time to switch it up. And honestly, what gravitated me toward this bag was I got these Converse already. These are the Undercover and Converse Attic version. You can get these in Japan. Next thing that I bought myself, kind of clothing related, but I got these Gundam Asus headphones right here. And I've been searching for this collection for a while. Ever since I got a gaming PC, I don't really game, I honestly just use it to edit and for work. But I got the keyboard, I got the mouse pad, now I want the mouse. And I was finally able to get the headset for a good price. So let me just put this on. And yeah, I love this headset. For those who've been gaming with me, you know my mic quality was garbage. Sound like I was speaking out from a toaster. So now that I finally got this, and y'all can't see it, but it lights up on the side. I'm for sure gonna take a fit pic in this. I just love it. You can take out the string. Yup. These are not no AirPod Maxes, you feel me? How do I watch it? I got the switch right here. Yeah. Alright, and the next thing I copped, shout out to Etsy. Shout out Lucas Sabat. He kind of put me onto this. Not even kind of, he did put me onto this. But it's this bracelet right here, which is made of just individual watches. So you can see, turn it around, I got kind of tight. But yeah, it's like made up of like 5 different watches that don't work and turn into a bracelet. And yeah, I saw a video of him rocking it and I was like, I need that. Found out on Etsy, and I've been eyeing it for a while, but since it's my birthday, I figured I'd finally cop it. One of my favorite purchases. I had an uncle said it's very feminine, and that's when I knew I was doing something right. When your uncle start talking shit about your clothing, that's when you know it's drippy. Unless it's not, you know, then it's just bad. But this one, yeah, I knew I did something with this one. Okay, so my microphone on my camera let me down, so I'm about to do another voiceover. But yeah, next pickup, this is coming straight from Korea, and y'all know how I feel about Korean brands. Like, look at me pointing my hands out, like they really on the come up. And shout out to this brand, This Is Never That. Honestly, just off the name is really why I mess with them, but then a lot of designs have been really clean. But here it is right here. We got these over dyed green pants. And let me just say for the record, like, shout out to my cousin, because in 7th grade, he put me on to wearing green pants. I didn't know that was a thing. I didn't know that was allowed, to be honest. But he showed me some green pants, and ever since then, I've been a fan. So seeing these was, like, perfect, because it's just over that green. Almost looks like some blue denim, like, the way they just, like, kind of, like, I don't know what the process is, but yeah, and then we see like these cracked patterns going on. It's what really made me like them. So here it is on body. I feel like it just hits really clean, especially in the sun too. And the fact that they're carpenter pants too is a little nice touch. I do appreciate that. And yeah, so I got those. It was on sale for like $100, but to get free shipping, you need to pay a certain amount. So a dude like me is always gonna try to get that free shipping. So I just looked on the site, ended up finding this Felix the Cat scarf. So I added it to my cart, and pretty comfortable scarf, I gotta say. I have another Verdi. It's the Verdi PSG scarf, and that one is like not warm at all. But this one actually keeps me warm. So yeah, here it is. I probably put it on like that, wear like a turban, wear it around my neck. However, I'm gonna experiment with it. But yeah, shout out, this is never that. All right. Next thing we got, hey, since it's my birthday, shout out to my mom because she came through and got me a birthday gift, and pretty much I just sent her like a little wish list, and she got me some stuff off the Stussy website. So first things first is we got the Stussy twill nylon moto jacket, just like this little biker jacket right here. And I really like this. When it first came out, I always wanted these type of jackets. It's just that I didn't want to get like, I don't know, some cheap one, just because I feel like and it hit crazy. But also I didn't need no like crazy leather, right? I'll only be paying like $800 for leather. So this one was like the perfect one. So a couple things I like is I just like the stitch line that goes around the whole jacket. It reminds me of these Stussy pants that I have also. So yeah, the inside is also padded, so it is really comfortable. And also my next favorite touch is just all these little like balls that they got on every single zipper. Like this zipper right here actually makes it so like if you want to get the cuffs tighter, you can. But I like to leave it open just so people know I can do that. Okay, here it is on body. I'll be feeling real clean in this one. And yeah, you know, it's a little, it's different. I never really had something like this. So yeah, I'm rocking with it. And on top of that, my mom also got me this DC rug, so shout out to her for that. Thanks, mom. Love you. Alright, y'all, the next item I cop, I'm really happy about this one because I got it for a big steal. It's from, you know, Undercover. That good Undercover, that good Undercover. And this is that Arts and Craft corduroy Sherpa jacket with the horizontal corduroy going on, not vertical. So I thought that unique touch. And yeah, I got this for $200 shipped from the Philippines. The guy said it cost $68 to ship it. This is a size 3, and man, like, I was super hyped about getting this one. But I do gotta say, it didn't fit as I like, even though it is a size 3. So curse these damn Japanese sizes. But yeah, here it is. As you can see, like, bro, fur lining going all the way in the inside. It's coming out the pockets. And I love how you can just kind of see it, like, twilled out. So like if you look closely, like yeah, you see all the Sherpa line. It almost looks like it's been pulled a little, so it's a little more extra exposed, which I think is a really nice touch, just so people can like barely see it. Just the little subtle details I think are really nice. Another cool details on this is just like the zippers they got on the sleeves. Also adjusts the side, and there's a zipper that runs through the back. And hey, if anyone in the comments can let me know what the purpose of those zippers are, like please, because like I just zipped it open just so you know people see I could do that. Like I got that functionality, you feel me? But like when you open it, like it's not much exposed right there, so I'm kind of confused. But yeah, here it is on body. I wore it under a hoodie and it was mad tight, so I think I can't really lay it with this one, unfortunately. And yeah, also I'm not too crazy about how it looks on me, to be honest. It looked better in my head. Maybe I don't know what it is, maybe just because like I feel like I look boxy or whatever when I wear this. But we gonna experiment with it. But hey, shout out Undercover, man. For this next piece, I'm glad to finally own something from this brand, because I've been wanting something from them, specifically the coin pouch, the Verdi one. So if you guys know what I'm talking about, this is a jacket, a biker jacket slash long sleeve slash garment of some sort from Black Means. Just made of denim, just different materials. I really don't know what's going on. It's hard for me to describe this clothing. I just know when I saw this, I wanted it. And the fact that it was so cheap, I think I got it for $110 shipped to the States. I just knew I had to cop it. And that's when I realized why I bought so much stuff for my birthday, is because I was just getting back-to-back steals. So yeah, here it is. As you see it, there's like the stripe indigo pattern going on the side, and then we have like the main denim going up front, and it's like almost like this koi fish looking denim. I don't really know how to describe it. And then yeah, then we got zipper details going along the front, with some of them having the balls on the zipper. And then pretty much what happens is that main zipper up front, when you fold it down, you'll see more of like the stripe pattern that's on the sleeves come out. So almost folds out just like that Stussy biker jacket that I got. And when I first got this, this is definitely a little out of my style, but I just figured like for that price, I might as well experiment. And I was figuring out ways to rock it. So like here it is on body. And I kind of figured out that like, if I want to, I can kind of like fold the insides in. So it's almost like a cardigan of some sorts, or like maybe like a flannel. I can also have them out. So just having a different way styled. I can also just button up all the way to the top, which I see myself wearing. So it's kind of like a long sleeve, but also kind of looks like a vest, like a utility vest or something. So yeah, really crazy piece. I mean, Black Means, like, I really love their focus on just like leather goods and just like upcycling or whatever they do, honestly. Like, it really is some next level stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna get one of those coin pouches though for sure. And yeah, shout out Black Means. Alright y'all, for this next one, I'm pretty hyped about this one. One of my favorite brands of all time, definitely my top 5. And I love their Varsity Jacket specifically, so the fact that I was able to get one of these had me super hyped. So yeah, we got this human made tiger Varsity in the black and gray colorway. And this is straight from Japan, straight from Bai. As you see the Chanel patch on the back, see on the front, we got the leather on the side. And yeah, I was just one day shopping on the site. I've used it before to order a pair of capital pants, but yeah, I was just shopping on the site and I kind of forgot how it works. So I ended up going to like the processing page and I clicked the button and I thought there'd be one more page, but nah, it just immediately charged my PayPal account. So I got the charge. I was like, oh, bet. I guess I'm about to get this jacket. So yeah, honestly, here it is on body. I feel like it fits really good. So I'm super hyped about this one. And yeah, one thing I will say though is like, I got it for a super steal, like 300 ish. And when I got in, I'm not gonna lie, I'm not sure if it's real or not. It came straight from Japan and the tags and stuff look good, so I really don't know. If it's not real, I'm just charge back. But at this point, I really don't care. I'm just glad I have it. So yeah, shout out Human Made. Okay, last three items I copped were from Issei right here. So we got the good Issei Sport label jackets. We got one in the gray colorway with the care label on the back, and then we got the other IS on the navy zip up. And man, I always wanted something from the Sport label, and I always just wanted more stuff from Issei Miyake. Like, LA only had like this one button up from them, so just adding to the collection. RP first of all. And yeah, so just having one of these, I was able to get it for a bundle deal, so I just kind of added to my order. Originally, I wanted the thing in the back. I'll show it off later. But yeah, pretty much it's just like these zip-up jackets that have the graphic on the back. And you know, I'm very big on the graphic on the back. I really like just when I can like walk in front of someone and they see the design on my back. I find that very appealing. So yeah, these are just kind of like regular zip-up jackets. Here's some of the differences in the details though. As you can see on the collar, got like this little lining, and then on the bottom too, got like these rectangular patterns going on, so it does kind of differentiate it from like other zip ups. At first I thought it was just like some regular stuff, so at least they tried, you know, it's a little different. Also, these are quite thin, so like it's not gonna help me for the weather, but I digress. Here's the other one, and I think this is the part where my voice comes back. So
okay, my battery died, but as I was saying, right here, here it is, this material, this stuff at the bottom. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, these don't fit that great though. They're a little tight. They're not gonna help me with the cold, but I'm just glad to own it. And I got it for a really good price. Wait till I show you the next thing I caught. And this is the last thing, by the way, but it's a pretty much like a little bomber type jacket from High Sporting Goods. And what really got me was this globe right here. Like I said, graphics on the back, my favorite. And as soon as I saw this, I was like, yeah, I want that. So here's the front right here. Couple details I want to show off. You got like this globe going on the zip right here. You got some globe on the buttons. Really nice detail. You got these like white like stripes right here that give me football vibes, which I like. And just navy all around. I will say though, I thought this was going to be a much thicker jacket, but this is more of like, it's a very light jacket, as you can see. Just this cotton blend going on. And just by itself, I wasn't too crazy about it, but then once I layered it with a hood, so let me show you guys the on-body outfit. But yeah, you see what I'm saying? Like, just by itself, not too crazy about it, but when I put on a hood and that globe on the back, ooh, yeah, I love that. Oh, I love that. So yeah, I got this jacket and the other one for 400 shipped from like Malaysia or whatever. So yeah, crazy deal. So this is the whole reason why I even bought all this stuff, you know? Like, I was just getting deal after deal after deal. And it's just like, all right, We're gonna make this birthday better and better and better. And yeah, that's pretty much the haul. That's everything I bought for my birthday. Appreciate the love you guys been showing me. Like, subscribe, comment, do all that. And I just wanna let you guys know in advance, I am planning on going to Japan in June. And I'm gonna be there for a month. And my goal is, I'm vlogging every single day I'm there. So every single day, I'm gonna try to make it a movie, I'm gonna try to make it interesting, whatever. So I hope you guys subscribe, tap into that. And yeah, thanks for watching, y'all. Let me know what your favorite was too. Bye.
Something like a boat you maybe think of. Maybe you'd like to have a yacht like that. You're gonna need some spare cash.